Hey, horsey people. All right, we're going for part three. I'm transferring from a bit to a rope halter. Now that Buddy's out of the way, I can get to my points better and not have to worry about poor old Mr. T. Okay, so now I'm gonna go ahead, since I showed you the one rein, because I can ride with one rein when I got two reins. So I'm gonna just tie this up, and normally this rope is too short for Mr. T. I like to get longer reins because he's got a longer neck, but since he's already wearing his halter and I don't really need a whole lot of pulling, this is going to work just fine. All right, Mr. T. My goodness, Mr. T. Sweaty. He's a sweaty boy. Good boy. Stand. Okay. So now I have two reins on Mr. T. He's gonna... Buddy's gonna cry because he thinks we're leaving him. But you'll notice I'm still riding with one rein. I'm just using my left rein, even though I have two. The only difference is I don't have to switch. So I'm gonna use the other rein, just one rein. Again, I'm riding with one rein, not two. So I gave him a little leg there, trying to get some of his piss and vinegar out. He's kind of reacting to Buddy. So he's kind of running. A lot of people will tell you, don't let your horse do this. They learning to run off with you. It's dangerous. I got to trim those trees. So I'm going to let this T. Did you get my leg on that fog wire, boy? So he's going to figure out, I'm going to run along the fence line and get Buddy jacked up. See him bucking and rearing. He is being an absolute maniac. Oh, shit. Hang on, Mr. T. Let's get this video done here. Buddy's preoccupying me. So I'm going to get him to back up again. If your horse can do this, if you were on the ground and you want your horse to back up, what would you do? You would pull back on the lead rope and direct him to back up. And that's what I'm doing now. Same thing as if we're on the ground. I'm letting his head know, hey, follow your head. I want you to back up. Okay, I'm walking off to the left. Follow this lead rope. There you go. So he's following the lead rope. I want you to stop. I'm on him. I'm going to lean back, give him a good cue, let him stop. Okay? I want you to follow the lead rope. If I was on the ground, here, walk with me this way, Mr. T. Follow the lead rope. Can you tell I haven't ridden Mr. T in a while? He is ready to go. And he doesn't like getting just saddled up to do this crap. So I'm going to do a little neck reining with him. Loose reins, having him turn a little bit. Having him turn without pulling his head. Don't try this with your horse. People want to try neck reining and it just doesn't work. If you want a neck rein, your horse should know how to do it. See, Mr. T ain't even doing it right there. His head should have turned immediately. And he runs me into that bush again. I'm about fed up with that. So I'm going to go ahead and get a hold of him and let him know to knock it off and pay attention to me and say, hey, quit pulling on this rope halter. Give me your head. And now he's going to lighten up a little bit. I'm goofing off. I'm paying attention. I'm trying to be light. And he's getting confused. And he's running me into trees and doing all this bullshit. Somebody else will ride him and go, that horse tried to kill me. He tried to knock me off a tree. He didn't do that. I was letting him do that. He won't do it now because I'm going to stop him and tell him what to do. So know the difference when somebody tells you, If you ride that horse, he'll run you by a tree and try to knock you off. He'll run you under a limb, and horses don't do that. People don't control them and let them do that, and then so they don't have to be a dummy and say, I don't know how to ride, they say the horse did it. Mr. T ran me on those bushes because I let him, not because of him. So, I didn't tell him to move, so he's going to back up. He's going to drop that head. So until he did that, he's going to, and again, I haven't worked on him while I haven't ridden him. He's doing okay. I'm not worried. People are going to be like, that horse ain't trained, and he don't, this horse will do anything I want to do when I want him to do it. But I'm not that serious, and I'm not, I don't ride him every day, and I expect this. It's not a big deal. Riding in one rein, and again, Mr. T had a tie-down, a big long shank, pang, bit, twisted, shaffle, wire, port, you name it, he had it. And you used to have to be hard and heavy-handed, and he learned to run through it, and he didn't care about the pain, and he was a maniac. And that's why everybody wanted to kill him, because they said he was dangerous. He can do the same thing in a rope halter if somebody gets on him and don't know how to ride. I want to go this way, I'm going to direct rein, I'm going to pick up this rein and point his head that way. I want him to go this way, I'm going to point his head this way. I want him to go this way, I'm going to point his head this way. I want him to go straight, I'm going to stop pulling his head. I want him to turn left, I'm going to pick up this rein, and he's going to turn left. I want him to stop going left, I'm going to let go of the pressure. And he's going to walk under the tree, because he's a stupid horse. No, because I didn't move him around the tree, because I didn't stop him from the tree. And he's still watching Buddy. Buddy's calmed down a little bit, but he's still over here looking over the fence like he's going to have a heart attack, because Mr. T's getting ridden and he ain't. So anyway, riding with a halter is very simple. I've got horses that have been ridden for a bit forever, and people go like, oh, my horse can't ride a rope halter. I go, really? I go, give me a rope halter, I'll ride him. They're like, no, he's going to hurt you. I go, give me a rope halter. I get on him within 10 minutes, the horse is riding in a rope halter. And they're sitting there all dumbfounded with their mouth open going, oh, that's amazing. It's a miracle. It's not a miracle. Your horse already knows how to ride in a halter. He knows how to tie, he knows how to lead. If he can do all that in a halter, then you can get on him in a halter. But you need to train yourself. You need to know not to panic and pull. And oh my God, he's going to run off and I got to pull. And your hands are up and you're off balance. And the horse is panicking like, I'm getting all these mixed directions. What do I do? Ah! You need to work on you. And you do that better in a small enclosed area with a fence. So instead of worrying about him running off in a car, running you under a tree, running off, tripping, traffic, getting away, running to another, you don't have to worry about all that. All you have to worry about is yourself and training your hands. Soft hands make soft horses. You need to train yourself to where when I pick up these reins, it means something. Mr. T's reins are laying down on him. That means nothing, and he knows that. Watch what happens when I pick up these reins. Watch his head. Watch him look for something's about to happen. He knows something's about to happen. So I'm going to let him know this is what I want. I picked up the reins so we could turn left and walk to the fence. We can turn left and walk back. So we can turn left and stop. So we can turn right and stop. And now we can back up. And we can back up. And I lay the reins down, and he knows I'm not getting any clues. Now, that little half step, I don't like that. He's about to take another half step. Not a fan of that, but that's okay. He's not moving. Reins are down. Now I can move my hands without affecting him. Now I'm still keeping my body centered. I'm still keeping myself centered, but I can move my hands, take my hat off, do all this stuff without affecting him. If I got a rein in the hand, and I'm doing this, and I'm doing... That's all confusing your horse. Your horse learns to ignore the reins. I don't want that. I want these reins to mean something. When I pick them up or touch them, it means something. If I pick them up, I'm about to ask him for something. And I may ask him just for a flex. He's not getting it. I'm going to try to get him a flex here. Good boy. No, just a flex. in a while, he didn't know what I wanted. He's like, dude, for the last 20 minutes, every time you pull on a rein, you wanted me to go. I moved and I got released. I thought that was the right answer. Now you changed the right answer on me. I'm just refining. Sometimes you start with big movements and then I refine. My house fan just kicked on top to move air out of the attic because obviously got over 100 something degrees in the attic, so that fan kicks on. So if it's loud in the speaker, sorry. So again, reins mean something. Your hands need to communicate with the horse. You need to feel comfortable doing this in a small area to where you don't have to worry about running off, tripping, fearful, you can't do it. Is he gonna run off? Is he gonna trip? Can I handle it? Once you get comfortable with one and two reins, then you're gonna be able to ride in a halter with no problem. That didn't mean go. See, a lot of times when I touch him, a lot of times I have to condition him sometimes when we're standing here, before I take off, I go, all right, let's go, Mr. T. And he's learned now when I touch him that means go. I didn't mean to teach him that. That's called classical conditioning instead of operant conditioning. Back up. If I meant to teach him that, it'd be operant because I give him a change response reward. So when I touch him, I have to desensitize him now saying, stand still. When I touch you, it doesn't mean move. When I touch you, it doesn't mean move. Pressure, release. I'm talking for Mr. T. Confusion, what do you want? Release. Is he asking me something? I don't know. I stood here. Release. I'm not moving and he's stopping. Must be the right answer. Pressure, release. Pressure, release. If I want my horse to learn, I have to learn what I'm teaching and what I'm saying. So, hopefully, good boy, Mr. T. I haven't slid off him off his butt in a long time. Poor old Mr. T. He's a good old boy. So, hopefully you learned something. Hopefully you get that it's not the horse, you. And I'm going to let old Mr. T go back out to the pasture. I didn't ride him that hard. So I'm probably not going to brush him down. He's probably going to have a saddle slot, but he'll go out there and roll. I didn't work him a whole bunch. He should be fine. But he's crying because he's a poor abused horsey. You're a good old boy. Yes, you are. Alright. Oh yeah, he doesn't look that bad at all. So I'm going to give him a cookie, but I'm not giving him a cookie to train him. I'm just giving him a cookie so he doesn't associate every time he gets a ride with a bad thing. Ooh, those good horse cookies, Mr. T. Ooh, he likes the little horse cookie. Ooh, he's a good boy. He's a good boy.
Let me get Laura without the head.
Good boy! Woo! He bit my lip off! You should never feed a horse, because he'll bite you! Whatever. He was untied and didn't even know it. So let me,
Wow, I gotta go give those guys some water. Buddy's out there with the water machine.
and he looks like he's drinking low. So I'm gonna go let Mr. T in. Look at Buddy, he sees Mr. T, he's like, dude, why ain't you out here with me? He got a good little workout too, running around acting like a damn fool. Let me go let him in his cage. Come on, Mr. T, you go out there with Buddy. Because you shouldn't have horses eating cut clippings. So obviously it didn't traumatize Team Mr. T too much, because he's just in there and Buddy's over there looking at him like a poor sad horse being abused, about to get a beating. You ready for your YouTube beating, boy? You're in big trouble. You know as soon as this camera goes off, you're getting it. Katie, bar the door, mister. That's it. You're in big trouble. Whatever, dude. Okay, now Mr. T's decided to come on out. Come on, Mr. T. Now, see, I can help Tanner. He wants to stay in there and eat, but I want him to go back in his cage so I can close this door and so he can get a drink. So I'm going to go ahead and back this up so you can see me go in there and get him to this gate. And all I'm going to do is put pressure and a little draw. So watch this. Is creating a draw, and Mr. T, instead of going to the gate, he is being drawn to that fence because Buddy's like, come here. So his herd instinct is overpowering my drive to get him in there. Can I get him in there? Sure, I want to get him in there. I'm gonna go put pressure on him and you're gonna see him running that gate. Mr. T, get you in. And there goes the happy horses. We're free! That mean old human! The mean old human! So they're gonna play and bond a little bit because Buddy missed him, Mr. T missed him. They'll go back to the corner to get away from the mean guy with the saddle and the harassing. Wow, I really got to get far over here. Where'd they go? There they are. All right, so they're happy horses. Hopefully you got something out of that. And we'll go ahead and end that there because I can't hold this still.